हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर पीसी कंबोडिया, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंग्लिश, बीएसआर, गवर्नमेंट आर्ट्स कॉलेज, अलवर, राजस्थान. दिस वीडियो इज़ फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ बीए पार्ट सेकंड इंग्लिश लिटरेचर. सिंस द कोर्सेज आर ओवर, सो दिस वीडियो डील्स विद द क्वेश्चन एंड आंसर सेशंस. इन दिस वीडियो वी take up short type of questions and answers. So I begin the questions and thereafter I shall be giving their answers, and the students thereafter can revise with the help of these questions and answers. So the first question is, about whom does the owl complain to the goddess moon in the elegy written in a country churchyard by Thomas Gray? The owl complains to the goddess moon about an intruder. So the intruder over here is the poet Thomas Gray himself. He does not return to his home because he was in a depressed mood, so he remains over there in the compound of the graveyard. He has none of such intentions to disturb the owl, but owl was not in a habit to see intruder at the night time, so the owl is making a complaint to the goddess moon. The next question, which are the agencies responsible for awakening people early morning in the elegy written in a country churchyard by Thomas Gray? The agencies that are responsible for awakening the people early morning are the breeze, that is flow of wind. And that flow of wind brings pleasing smell, ether. It enters the nostrils of the persons sleeping all around, and when they sense this pleasing smell in the breeze, they wake up. Or the twittering of the swallows from the thatched roof is also responsible for awakening people. The next question, why people who have been buried in the graveyard of that place were unable to become famous poets or musicians or the great leaders? The persons who have been buried after their death in the graveyard of that village could not become famous poets or musicians or leaders because the stars of luck never bloomed on them. Then they were poor and opportunities were also not given to them, so they couldn't become famous personalities. Then the next question, elegy generally give a death message. So which of the stanza gives the death message in the elegy written in a country churchyard by Thomas Gray? The stanza that gives the message about death is, boasts of heraldry, pomp of power, all that music, all that beauty gave, awaits alike the inevitable hour, paths of glory lead but to the grave. So this stanza gives the death message. That is, the end treatment is the same for all persons, whether rich or the poor, or the low-born or the high-born, or common people or the herald. Then the death is essential. The death will spare none. So this stanza gives the death message. I once again repeat this stanza. Boasts of heraldry, pomp of power, all that beauty, all that wealth gave, awaits alike the inevitable hour. Paths of glory lead but to the grave. Then the next question, name any two poetic devices which Thomas Gray makes use of in the elegy written in a country churchyard. Several poetic devices have been used by the poet Thomas Gray in the elegy. We come to the poetic device which is there in the very beginning of the elegy. In the very beginning of the elegy, we come across the poetic device transferred epithet. Transferred epithet in one word is called as hyplege. The spelling is hyplage. Transferred epithet, as the name suggests, epithet means adjective. Adjective is being transferred. We see that the farmer is weary, according to the poet. But the farmer is weary, and weary way has been written. So the way is not weary, it is the farmer. So weary, that is tired. The adjective weary or the tired should have been used for the farmer, but the poet deliberately makes use of it for the way. So we understand that this adjective should have been used for the farmer who is returning to his home, driving his cattle just in front of him. And since he has done the toil or the labor throughout the day, so he is tired. But he is not being shown as tired, but the way is being shown as tired. This weary should have been used for the farmer, but not for the way. But this poetic device is there, so we will have to accept. Then another poetic device is the cold personifications. Several personifications are being used by capitalizing the initial word. Say, for example, penury, that is poverty. Poverty is being shown as animation. So this P is capitalized of poverty, and several other cold personifications have also been used. We come to the next question. Name the stanzaic form and the rhyming scheme in the elegy written in a country churchyard. The form of the stanzaic form is quatrain, that is a stanza of four lines. Then the rhyming scheme in the elegy is A, B, A, B. Name the poet who composed the poem London. The poem London is a short poem, but it has several layers of meaning. It was composed by William Blake. Then next question, describe the facial looks of the people whom the poet William Blake meets while strolling in the streets of London. The facial expressions of those people whom the poet William Blake meets are full of worries, and they are crying. They have been handcuffed. Their mental condition is also not appropriate because they have been captivated mentally. Then, whose cries does the poet William Blake listen while strolling in the streets of London in the red light areas? William Blake listens to the cries of prostitutes and harlots while strolling in the streets of London at the midnight hours. Next question. In the poem London, who is lying outside the compound wall of the Royal Palace and that person is bleeding? The person who is bleeding and who is lying outside the compound wall of Royal Palace is a soldier who has been wounded in the battlefield. Now he has come to the Royal Palace. He is asking the king for his justice. Since the war is over, he fought for his empire, but now no one takes care of him and he is demanding justice. We shall be continuing with this question answer sessions in our next video. Thank you so much.